Hello guys, we're the Habibi Brothers.
Hello.
And today we're gonna watch, we found the cheapest homes in Texas. Houston, Texas.
If we go to USA, this is the first date, man. Texas.
First
destination.
Okay. I said first date? Yes. Gonna kill you.
No. Haram, man. The first destination because of the
barbecue.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go.
You can buy this exact home right here today for $137,000.
100, what do you think, man? 130.
I have to see the inside.
This is the cheapest.
In Houston.
In Houston.
Not cheapest. I seen some big ones, but in rural towns. But this is like not rural at all.
And even the most expensive home in this neighborhood, we're going to get you in here in just a second, is only $207,000. And you can see why almost every single home on this street is sold. They have sold 25 homes in this neighborhood last week alone.
And the reason is
because you can't find new construction homes at these prices anywhere else. In fact, we just ran the payments on this exact home, and they come out to $1,100 per month. That's cheaper than renting an apartment, and you get,
but you own it. They own, but riba. What they say?
Usury.
Yeah.
You think so?
Yeah. Come on. Yeah. What do you think?
For sure.
Our
yeah,
country
is America. This is America.
Well, Islamic country.
Yeah.
And Islamic.
Yeah.
And all the banks use usury. Yeah.
That was stupid.
Who actually own the home. And home prices, if you haven't noticed, they are going up here in the Houston area. We've got hundreds and thousands of people moving here every single day. So if you're looking to own a brand new construction home without breaking the bank, this is going to be as cheap as it could possibly get. And they really have options out here for everyone. This one's on the smaller side at $137,000, but we're also gonna be showing you one right over there for $153,000. But first, I wanna start with their big boy. I wanna show you their largest home starting.
I want to see the large one. I'm not gonna lie.
This is gonna be their biggest floor plan. This is actually a 3-bedroom, 2-story home. And what I love is it's actually got a cute little covered front porch. These homes are turnkey. They come with fridge, washer, dryer, which even builders in the $500,000-$600,000 range don't always come with a full appliance package. So they took out all of the kinks that would keep you.
I'll take an empty one, man. They raise the prices.
You think so?
I think so. Yeah.
I think they will make it. You're gonna see the fridge and you're gonna be wow.
Or they buy
the
in bulk.
Yeah.
Okay, maybe.
I think you're gonna be shocked now.
From being able to buy a turnkey home at such low prices. Now, as I mentioned, this one's being offered at $207,000, and this is the most expensive home that they're going to offer out here. And listen, before we show you inside of these, if you don't already know, my name's Kyler Ferris, and we get calls, texts, and emails every single day from people just like you that are looking to move to Houston. So if you're looking for a deal on a home like this one, go ahead and reach out to us. Our information is right there in that top comment. Just give us a call, shoot us a text, send us a quick email, or fill out that survey link, and we can get you all the information that you're gonna want on these awesomely priced homes. Now, come on in, and I think you'll be pleasantly surprised at how open this home actually is. This is a plenty good sized living room, and you have.
I did not expect it to be like this.
It's too big. It's good.
What the hell?
Right here on the
floor. How many rooms?
I'm gonna go ahead and close the door up for us so we
can. I think 200 is cheap for America.
I mean, it's 200 is cheap for Algeria. What the hell is insane? For this size.
Like,
in Houston, Texas.
In our money, it's like 4 billion.
4 billion dinars.
It's too much, 4 billion.
I don't think you are considering this is in Houston. This is like, imagine this is like in our cities.
Yeah. Houston, it's city.
Houston, Texas is, we watched the.
Yeah, I think you're right. Yeah, they are cheaper, much
it's cheap.
Cheaper.
They are cheap as hell.
We are living in a small town.
It's like the smallest town.
Yeah.
20,000 or somehow.
Yeah, some homes here like 2 billion.
Not 20,000, maybe like 15,000 lives here.
Two billion here, maybe
two. 2 billion for their money, like
100,000.
100K.
Yeah.
Not mess up our audio for you guys. So it's got this nice big 2-story open living room. It gets a lot of natural light. You get some
and this is
open windows.
Far from it, it would be like shithole. This one is beautiful.
It's mother. No, I think no building here is like regulated. Like
For building.
Fan cooling it off.
Anti-seismic.
It gets hotter here in the summer. I like this. You've got an extra little cubby underneath the stairs. little bit of extra storage. I love it. But check Harry this Potter out. These are nice finishes that you might not expect to be in that $137,000 to $207,000 price point. So this is real granite countertops. You've got the white, more modern shaker cabinets.
I love it.
And as I mentioned, this home
comes better than our house, man.
So you're going to get a stainless steel fridge. You're going to get a
brand stainless steel.
I told you they're going to like put the best
new cooktop. You've got a pretty good sized pantry too. Cornered pantry, plenty of room for your groceries. Pretty good sized sink, and really like these massive pullouts over here. Now underneath the stairs, you've got extra little space here for your full size washer and dryer. So you got your stackable.
This washing machine.
Washer and dryer. I think the one in the upside.
It's a weird one. I think the dryer is up.
Yeah.
And once again,
I'm struggling to find the words. With
washer, dryer, turnkey. You can move in day one. You've got everything that you need here. You actually have this little side door. This goes out to your yard. Now,
I want to see this, it, man.
Not all yards come fenced. You'll see if you qualify, and as long as you qualify, they'll go ahead and put a fence in for you.
Qualify? What the heck? Qualify. Oh, that's good. They don't just sell it. You have to be qualified. Maybe money.
A lot of people are waiting list.
Maybe.
But what the hell does it have to do with the fence, man?
If you
qualify, I think there is another meaning, man. Another meaning.
Yeah. I think if you like start purchasing, they will put your fence.
But then you need to get out here and mow. They'll tell us. See though that you get this nice lush St. Augustine grass. If you do have pets, you're gonna be perfect.
They told us that grass in the comments.
The hermit.
Our member tell us
loyal.
They
remember.
Yeah, lawyer member, the lawyers.
The grass is from
Algeria. Not the grass, the best one.
I think so, yeah.
Although we never seen it here. That was a surprise to us to read it.
They paint grass here with the green when some governor come.
Yeah, they paint it, yeah.
Oh, it's all yellow here, yeah. They paint
yellow, it. We don't have grass, man.
Yeah. They paint it.
Pets out here have a yard.
In major cities.
Come out here and play. But they also have a park here in the neighborhood. So you don't have to use your backyard to let the kids out and let them have a good time. Now, this is the master bedroom. And this is pretty long. It's not the widest room I've ever seen, but it's actually very, very long. And so you'd have plenty of room to put. I mean, you could fit a king size bed here, but you have room to wall it off right here. And then you'll still have plenty of room over in this area for full size dresser or a little seating area. Now coming in here, they've got the granite in the bathroom as well. It is a single vanity. They've got the drop-in porcelain sink, but you've got your shower tub combo. They carried the luxury vinyl plank into this room. But what I want you to check out is where you're standing, which is in the master closet. This thing is actually bigger than a lot of closets that we see in some larger homes that are twice the size of this room. You can get master closets much larger than the one that you see here. Now, because this one's not staged like the other ones we're gonna see, I wanna kinda show you what the layout here could look like. Now, you've got plenty of room in here. You could do a bunch of different configurations, but more than likely, I'd probably have some form of sofa along over here, a sectional here, and I'd probably mount my TV somewhere up over here, not directly next to the window. You could also corner it as well, so that you really have kind of a—
The roof is high.
He will show us the—
He showed us. No, the roof.
Dedicated living room space.
So high.
The other option that would work really well that would open up this place even more would be to run a sectional and corner it off here, have your little coffee table over here, and then I would probably end up mounting a TV somewhere up over here along this wall. That's gonna open it up a lot more. Now, as far as dining goes, you've got a couple different options. You could actually run kind of an informal dining table
probably
fit a six here pretty easily. You'd still have room for your bar stools with the chairs pushed in, and then it really wouldn't overflow into the living room all that much. So I want you to see, even though this is a 1,200 plus square foot home, you actually have room for that kind of informal dining room. Now, as soon as we get to the top of the stairs, you have this open loft area here.
I told you, man. I want to see the view
over down into the lower level. Yeah, so it's very much connected. You have an additional closet over here, and then you've got your window. You get tons of natural light up here as well. This is going to be your entrance into your attic, and then as you can see, you've got
you have upper
windows. Now,
yes,
this
course.
Is going to be the shared bathroom for the upstairs, full size.
Oh, it's not flat like
now. One thing you'll notice, they are marketing this as a three-bedroom home, but what you'll notice is we had one bedroom downstairs, you've got one bedroom upstairs. Now, this is a really good size room. Let me get the light in here for you. You've got your closet, which has plenty of hanging space. But as we come back out here to the loft, you'll notice that they put this closet in here for a reason. They are counting this as a bedroom, which I know it's kind of controversial.
What?
But for what it is for the price, it's got a closet and it's got room to fit an extra bedroom.
This is a new couple. It's too small for a big family.
One kid or two, yeah. Maximum.
So you could or use three, it as a two maybe. Bedroom.
You can fit three.
That's all that you need. A lot of people moving out here are buying this as a starter home or
yeah,
single or just a couple without kids. But even if you have kids,
exactly.
You've got a kid's bedroom up here for the kids to share. You've got a loft kind of play area, and then you've got the master downstairs. And so for $207,000 to get
fridge,
washer, dryer, blinds, a fenced in yard.
Yeah, we still sharing rooms. Now we are three. Yeah. We're three brothers.
In a turnkey neighborhood with a park with a pretty reasonable tax rate, I would say you're doing pretty good. Now this one I'm excited about because it is staged. This is on the little bit smaller side. This is kind of one of their medium-sized homes out here. And keep in mind, guys, these are really similar to the size of apartments. That's where we're getting these affordable price tags. But for people that want to own something and don't want to just throw that money away.
I think this is better than renting, man. Same price of renting.
But I hate to deceive, man. They say three bedrooms.
Who gives a shit?
I don't like this.
Listen, man.
Man,
if you pay that same price you pay in, you will be renting for all your entire life, owning nothing. I think this is better.
Yeah.
Yeah, on that price side.
Compared to us.
Compared to them, even them. They are renting.
Rent every month. This really is a great option. You're going to see a lot of appreciation here in this area. And with payments as affordable as $1,100 a month.
Renting,
yeah.
Not buying for $1,000.
No, people rent in the city like this.
Yeah, but how much is it?
Same.
1,000.
Yeah.
1,000 for rent.
Yeah, man.
What the fuck?
I think more.
Wow.
You should check out that video, man.
What the fuck?
How much you renting in the city? I think some people like 2,700.
This is not city. This. Come on, man.
I understand. I'm telling you just, but this has the upside of owning when you like finish with your payments.
Okay.
The other one just renting until you just have nothing.
Okay.
I can see why they're selling so many of these homes. So it's got this really cute front porch here as well. Again, they're calling this one a two bedroom. Really, it's a one bedroom with a loft, but I actually really like the layout on this one, probably the most. So as soon as you come inside, you're met with the staircase, but we're gonna head over this way. You've got the living room, and because it's staged, you can actually see, like I said, it kind of feels like an apartment. They've got their coffee table here. You got plenty of room to sit down. Exactly like I said over at the other house, I would probably mount my TV somewhere up over here. I'd probably just throw it on a swivel. You've got a plug down here. You could run it up and have no issues. But if you'll notice, if you look up, one of the things that really helps with these things being so small is that they've got these big tall ceilings. So they've got that upper window bringing light on into the house. And you actually have pretty good sized kitchen for this home. I love that they have the peninsula that kind of connects the living room over to the kitchen. You're not going to have any kind of dining area. You're just going to use these countertops. But let's be honest, I live in a 3,600 square foot home and I still eat over here on my bar stools. So you've got a pretty cool kitchen set up over here. I like the layout. Once again, coming with the appliances.
Oh, Whirlpool. It's famous.
What is it? The brand?
Turnkey. It's also coming with blinds. My house didn't even come with blinds when I bought it. So it is nice to have that. These usually cost a couple thousand dollars after you move in. So to be able to take out all of those hidden costs that you're hit with after you close on a home and package it all up into an affordable price is
amazing. Blinds cost out. Maybe all the windows.
For sure, man.
So you got your sink over here, stainless steel sink, stainless steel dishwasher, and then they went with a different cabinet color over here. They went with more of like a matte gray. So very modern color palette. This is actually a different luxury vinyl plank. I really like this one. This one's got like more of a real wood look. And then right over here, you've got your laundry just off of the kitchen. Super convenient.
It's all the way
stackable. Just give you an idea of kind of the size. So there you go.
Beautiful.
This is the real deal. And then you've got your pantry kind right over here. I kind of expected it to be.
Get out of here, boy.
It's a full size.
This shit, 100K.
Whatever, you name it. And then come back here. There is a bedroom here on this one.
I am nitpicking.
Nitpicking? You are crazy. You will never find this with 100K. Even here, man.
137, not 100.
Okay, 157 still.
Master bedroom. This looks to be a full-size bed. You could fit a queen in here. A king might be pushing it, unless you got rid of this dresser. But you've got your dresser over here. You've got your closet. No light in the closet. It's a little dark. And then coming out here, you've got your bathroom.
The
it's
fault?
Got your
no light.
Granite Ooh, countertops once good. Again. And then it's got your shower tub combination. And then we're going to head on upstairs to show you that other loft. Now, before we head upstairs, I really want to tell you exactly where we are today. We're actually here in Conroe, Texas. We're over on the east side of Conroe. And this is really where a lot of new development is taking place. This is where you're going to
be able to find lake beside them.
The most affordable houses.
Yeah, but how far, man?
How far, but at the city?
It's big. It's long, huge distance.
Long,
yeah, it's long.
Products that we've seen anywhere in the entire Houston area. But what's so cool is Conroe is booming. You're about 10 minutes from the local grocery store right here in this community, and you're about 18 minutes from downtown Conroe. Downtown Conroe is being revitalized. It's got a really cool vibe. It's got bars, restaurants, even a little bit of nightlife, which is surprising for Conroe. And then Conroe is exploding. You've got tons of commercial shopping. You've got
18 minutes from this. This is the dream, man.
Yep. Commercial shopping centers located all throughout the Conroe area. And so you really don't have to go into Houston for anything. You're just a...
You don't know need anything. What the hell is these stores?
That's huge.
Wow. Look how many, how big.
18 minutes. Wow.
But I don't know. I don't recognize the brands, to be honest. But still, it's still supermarket.
No Walmart here.
I think there will be no Walmart here.
I think in Boston. Nothing.
In Boston, yeah. Houston.
Yeah, Houston.
All right.
Literally all of your shopping needs. You even have Lake Conroe over on the west side of town. It's about a 25, 30 minute drive from where we're at right now.
And I told you, Lake.
Commute in and out of Houston.
Man, I feel depression.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is not, like, you will never find this here.
But it's too much for us, man. 137.
I understand, but... Like, even here, you never found it cheap as like.
Come on, man.
And the stores, like, close to you, lake close to you. That's good.
Yeah.
We actually have a couple of different options being here in this location. We're actually far enough east where you're about equidistant between I-45 and Highway 59-69. And so if there is any traffic, depending on where you're commuting here in the city, you're gonna have options on two of the major thoroughfares that will take you down into the Houston area. And another thing that we're finding that clients absolutely love about this neighborhood is it is part of Conroe ISD. So this neighborhood is zoned to Caney Creek High School. And because of all the growth that's going on over here, there's rezoning taking place. And so what that means is that with more people moving over to this area, there's more funding for the schools, which means the schools should continue to improve here in the next couple of years. And here's the crazy part here in this community. They actually-
More funding.
I don't understand how the US works.
We only have 40 homes left for sale because they're selling 40. Them so quickly. But here's the good news.
But if you buy two with 100 ones, better than the bigger one, no?
Why?
Much more space, man.
And the,
you combine them. There's the eat them.
Let's eat them. You
combine them.
Combine them together.
Yeah, I think so, no? Much more space. But
good idea. Yeah. If they let you,
you have to.
They have to let you.
You buy it. I think they said. They told me in the comments. If you buy something in America, you own the land.
I understand, but you have to get a permit. If you want to combine the house, shit. A lot of work,
maybe,
I think. Yeah.
Maybe. Tell us if I'm right. I'm not, or
inspector.
No. Some people are going to be like experts on this in the comments.
We're actually about to open a brand new community located just up the road in Willis, just north of Conroe, in another fantastic location. So if you fall in love with what you see today, do not worry, there are plenty of similar options for you. Now, before we head upstairs, one thing that I missed, I wanted to show you. If you're a pet lover,
for
got
dog.
Those furry friends, this is the perfect little nook. I love that the stagers did this. This is very smart. That would be the perfect place.
You it can is.
Throw in like a baby gate right here and have kind of like a wow. built-in kennel for your dogs whenever you go away.
Forget the dogs, man. This is for a kid.
It's a great setup, man.
Today. Yeah. Now, if you work from home, the stagers nailed this. They got the perfect setup upstairs if you did need a home office. Now, they have the loft set up as an office. So if you are working from home, it's got that perfect setup. You've got the natural light coming through here. Got a desk,
wow.
plenty of room.
They have the best designers, man. They make it spacious. And even so, it's
small, yeah.
Yeah, they are good.
Whatever kind of work done that you needed. But you could also use this as a secondary living room, playroom here on the second level, or they actually have it set up as a secondary bedroom. So you could easily come in and wall this off if you needed to. I did ask the salesperson, I asked him if they ever enclosed that. He said they have on a few of their floor plans, but you have a full bathroom right here on the second floor. So matching those cabinets, got the same granite countertops with the drop-in porcelain sinks. They've got it decorated nice, and you've got the shower tub combo. So you actually have a restroom on this floor plan on the first floor as well as the second floor. Now, last but certainly not least, this exact home is for sale right now for $137,000. And yes, it still comes with this really cute front porch, but as soon as you come inside, you are greeted with this nice downstairs living room. Come on in. It is staged, and you can see how it is intended to be set up. So you can kind of corner it exactly what we were talking over at the first house.
Cozy.
You could actually even have a bigger sectional in here, get rid of that nightstand, and have plenty of.
There is no furniture in the 200,000.
He said it's not staged yet.
Ah, okay.
Room to seat the family, and you still have that nice two-story open living area here. Plenty of room to mount a TV. They decided to put this kind of nice, I don't know what you call this, to be honest, but right over here at the front entry. And then you've got your kitchen peninsula, very similar to what we just saw. The difference with this floor plan is it doesn't have a downstairs bedroom, which actually kind of opens it up down here, gives it a little bit more room. This is where you're going to have your stackable washer and dryer, right here down on the first floor. And then this is your pantry. Pretty good size too. And then this one is going to come with your stainless steel appliances as well. They're just not currently in here now. What I do like is that this is a sink with no divider. So this is actually a really massive deep sink. You got your window to look out to get you some light. And this is gonna connect you over through into the backyard. And check out this view. There are some lots out here with some pretty decent sizes.
Wow.
So as you can see, you've got plenty of room out
there. It's a good view.
So if you are looking for a yard, not all of them out here are massive, but there are still a handful left that are gonna be decent size. So if you do have those pets.
I like this one. Kids to have, yeah, this is play, one. This is one looking private, better than the first.
Now listen,
even the
200.
Even the 200, yeah, because of the.
Even the, it's spacious, kind of. I know the first one is better, but this looking good.
Especially behind the fence, it's all open area.
Yeah,
I like that.
You're probably.
I think they will close the
build.
Yeah, they will build.
$137,000. What is the catch? Well, it's always size, and this is exactly what we're talking about. This particular unit's just over 700 square feet, and it is set up as a loft. So this is going to be the actual bedroom. Now, for some of you that are open-minded,
that's why.
Cool. It's open air. You've got great views out there. You get a lot of good natural light.
They sacrificed the bedroom downstairs.
Some bullshit.
The people who bought it, they did it.
Even have your own full bathroom right up here with granite countertops and a full shower tub combination. But this isn't going to work for everyone. And so I definitely want
you to know
in the comments below, which option would you pick? Are you going to go with the least expensive option, which is this one at $137,000? Or would you opt for option one, which is that bigger three bedroom option at $207,000?
They calculate everything for sure.
They don't mess around.
For sure.
Wow.
You gotta make them. But I think a lot of them are gonna be sold out. This is a great deal in America.
Yeah, I think this is a great deal. Even
maybe they are sold out. This is an old video, yeah?
He uses great techniques. Only 14 left. He's good.
But it's true though. He's not lying about anything.
Man, I hate the lying about three bedrooms and
Yeah, that was like
deceiving.
Like scam.
I hate this
scam.
In of course, business, man, you should be honest, man. Come on, man.
Yeah, if they close it, there will be that would be a room. They just
they say that to get you to see, maybe.
No, they can close it and it will be a bedroom. But it would be like,
can you modify it?
Yeah, for sure you can modify.
Modify it.
If you buy it, of course, man. Who cares?
I think this is a great deal.
I think if. Before you buy it, if you ask the salesman, they will like make adjustments for you.
But it's crazy, man. How expensive the home is. 200,000. It's a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah. The land should be free, man.
Yeah, it should be cheap, man.
Yeah.
I agree.
Ours too, man. Our countries.
I think this
the
is
most high.
I think this is trend all over the world,
man. We should stop this shit, man. Why is the land so expensive?
I don't know, man.
Yeah.
They're keeping us down.
Yep.
Okay, guys, really enjoyed this video.
Yeah,
make sure to like and subscribe. And see you guys in the next one.
See ya.